11 p.m., an officer, Ann Zablak, is reporting for duty on her overnight shift at the Lowell Police Department.
And then I have to go over here and test it.
The only thing I want to go over is...
After roll call...
Make sure he's calling me everything I do.
She took us along as she began her patrol of Massachusetts' fifth largest city.
So right now, we're headed downtown.
Zablak's been on the force for 3 years.
So that right there is my grandfather. My grandfather is a cop here in the city, and he used to have people come up to him and say, you help me out with this, you help me out with that. And I kind of wanted to do something with my life, like have people remember me a little bit for the good things.
She never knows what a call will bring, but has found her presence as a female officer can have an impact.
I think sometimes when I go to calls, people don't feel that they're, like I said, intimidated, so it takes their guard down a little bit.
But our investigation found Zablak and other women officers are a small minority in Lowell and across the state, where just 1 in 10 officers are female.
Policing has certainly changed a lot. It's really community focused. So it's not necessarily, okay, let's go out and get the bad guys.
Marie Cleary is a lieutenant with the Wellesley Police Department and president of the Massachusetts Association of Women in Law Enforcement.
Like it took the fire.
She says women often bring different perspectives and life experiences to policing.
Someone who was a victim of a sexual assault, human trafficking, domestic violence, things of that nature, might feel more comfortable speaking with a female officer.
Cleary says a barrier to diversifying departments is many girls and young women still see policing as a male-dominated field.
Until women see other women in a role, they don't see it as a viable career option.
Her association has done outreach, like scholarships, a youth academy, speaking to classes. But there are other reasons for the lack of female officers. Police chiefs tell us the civil service process limits their hiring discretion. It's based on an exam which automatically gives veterans added points. Whatever the cause, the effect is clear. Police forces in the state are overwhelmingly male. We surveyed 20 departments, small and large, around eastern Massachusetts earlier this year. Boston is 14% female, but most are under 10%, including Gloucester, Worcester, and Fall River. And there's another issue that can't be ignored.
I mean, there's just blatant sexual inappropriate statements made, inappropriate touchings.
Sexism and misogyny continue to plague police departments, according to attorney Tim Burke, who's currently representing about 20 female officers with gender discrimination claims.
There has been significant improvements, but to say that there aren't pockets of resistance, I think that's completely inaccurate.
Add more head movements.
Here in Lowell, one of the ways they're fighting the old image of law enforcement is making sure female officers are seen in the community, including by potential recruits at this boxing gym.
1-6, because I like to help people, whether it's here in a boxing ring or out in the streets. My main thing is just being a helping hand.
If there's a little girl watching this, seeing you, what do you want her to think?
I'd like her to think that if I can do it, she can do it. I don't want anyone to be discouraged just because you may not have the look of a typical cop. We all have our strengths, we all have our weaknesses. You know, we're here to help you, a man or a woman. Either way, though, we can do the job just as well.
Those officers are now sworn in and are in the middle of their field training program at the Lowell Police Department. You can take a closer look at the results from our statewide survey. We've posted them in this story on our website and the WCVB app. Karen Anderson, 5 Investigates.